Mini Chapter 83, A Unicorn's Horn of Invention by Herb. Within a few hours after receiving Shigem's phone call, Herb has given a heavy sigh, has opened ain't they freaky's code, has painstakingly removed every aspect of the game's option to blowtorch the homes and belongings of the street queens of Violet Street, and has smoothed over all the rough edges of code resulting from this removal. To judge from his expression, these actions have felt right. He sits there with a tired, wise smile, looking anew at the rest of this slick but somewhat generic evocation of this street grid. Then, in an access of unHerb-like friskiness and flamboyance, he tap dances off and away through the code around him, adding what amounts to a grand, twirly unicorn's horn of his own invention. This version of Downtown L.A., he decrees, will be graced by an advertising agency that'll ensure beautiful images of all the street queens of Violet Street are posted on every block. Some of these will be advertising things, while others won't be advertising anything, but will just be there anyway, for the simple reason that every one of them makes the city so much lovelier for her presence, injecting a flash of transcendence and a foreshadow of fierce beauty into the face of dreariness, laziness, and smallness. See them up there now, from Figueroa Street across to Alameda Street, and from Chinatown down to the Fashion District. See them mounted high on every billboard in the sun, or at dusk projected huge upon the blank façades of warehouses, or crisp against the night above the skyscrapers' tops. At last it is done. Happy with his changes, Herb picks up his phone, hesitates, then taps a number. "Hi, Herb," answers Jamie. "Hi, I just wanted to let you know I had a phone call today from Shigem. It was about the downtown environment in Ain't They Freaky. He must have been playing it at your place, I guess." "Oh, Shigem called you? Yes, he must have been here in the guest wing," says Jamie carefully. Vivid is his memory of watching Shigem make that very phone call from Violet Street, and of the promise Herb made down the phone line. But did Herb then keep the promise? "He made me see I should make a few coding changes in that environment, so yeah, I went ahead and made them. I assume you're familiar with how it was there in downtown, so if you take another look now, you'll see what I've done. You made Shigem, so I guess you probably have an idea what he was talking about." As Jamie takes in these words and decides that he believes them, a cautious pleasure opens in him. "I shall take a look, yes. I'm overjoyed you did that. Welcome, Herb." "Sure. You built a persuasive beast there. And, talking of those beasts of yours, how's the Platinum Raven doing these days?" says Herb, sounding sheepish. "She's a stunner, by the way." "Yes, thanks for hacking her code the other day," says Jamie. "I'm sure she loved being filled up with the black slab and almost killed by it on that railroad by the desert. Cheers for that." "Sorry, I do feel a little guilty there, I admit. Still, at least Amber and Evelyn were there on the bridge to scoop her up, so at least she turned out well in the end, right?" "Mm-hmm," says Jamie dryly. "Yes, I do believe she has." Can he trust these seeming apologies by Herb? His instincts tell him yes, and right now he would love to share his own excitement at having just incarnated the Platinum Raven as his fifth beast, but better to refrain from such enthusiasm until he has looked at Bangdad's downtown and verified Herb has indeed changed it as described. "Boy, was she a hot hack," muses Herb. "I tell you, hacking her code was like making love. Oh yeah, I mean really. In fact, I don't mind telling you, Jamie, man to man, throughout the whole hack, I was just..." "Okay, Herb," Jamie cuts in. "Thanks so much for the call, and do let's meet and have a catch-up in the next few days, yes?" "Oh, sure thing, yes. Bye, Jamie. Bye." Jamie puts the phone down, then fires up Ain't They Freaky so as to inspect Herb's improvements. While it loads, the pleasure in him expands from caution into confidence. Those beasts coming on nicely, it would seem.